start with this dueling data, because this advisory committee is taking a look at things, and it's not just clear cut. I think a lot of times we go into these meetings and, you know, we have a good idea of what might happen, but right now so much is unknown.
Right, that's correct. There are sort of two competing paradigms here. There is very interesting information and data out of the Pfizer study from Israel that certainly shows that a third dose administered to a group of patients over the age of 60 reduced the risk of overall infection by 11 times less likely to get infected and almost 20 times less likely to get hospitalized and die. However, there's this competing paradigm that suggests that if the vaccine is so effective against the most important outcomes, hospitalizations and death, what is the possibility that we wait for ongoing data? So it'd be very interesting to hear today what the committee says.
All right, I just want to go over what we do know for sure, and that's that the vast majority of vaccinated people are still well protected by these vaccines. It's not that they're failing.
That's correct. So we know that roughly 51% of Americans are fully vaccinated. I think upwards in the mid to high 70s have received at least the first vaccine. We are not seeing an uptick in hospitalizations or deaths in the fully vaccinated population. And so the vaccines are overwhelmingly safe and overwhelmingly effective. What we still need to do is reinforce the importance of vaccines in the millions of Americans who are yet to receive the vaccination, but the vaccines are safe and effective and an important tool in the war against COVID.
All right, I want to talk about this publication, The Lancet. There was obviously the FDA reviewers in there, and they appear to be not convinced of a need for boosters. And the quote was, overall data indicate that currently U.S. licensed or authorized COVID-19 vaccines still afford protection against severe disease and death in the U.S. So that, seems to be making the case that we don't need this right now. But if not now, then when?
So what we know from data earlier this month and a little and slightly before that is that the rates of breakthrough infections has slowly started to creep up. And there is a concern that at some point, as these infections continue, that we will see a tip over into an increase in hospitalizations and increase in deaths. So there is a public health perspective that says to nip this in the bud before we get there. However, I think the other side of the coin is that if we are preventing the most severe outcome, there may be an opportunity here to get more data to find out a more targeted surgical approach to the distribution of the third dose. Does that go to people who are at highest risk? For example, those 65 and older, or 60 and older, as they did in Israel, those who are on the front line, police, firefighters, physicians, and nurses. So I think there is some very interesting discussion to be had today, but I think we'll walk out of today, hopefully, with some increased information about the right people to target this to and how to best distribute it. All right,